in January of this year, Janet and I managed to make reservations at Granite Park Chalet. We booked it for two nights. The trail up there is marked in orange or yellow, kind of, and the chalet is marked, is circled in red. So that's the hike we'll be taking up. It's 7.6 miles from Logan Pass to Granite Park Chalet. Okay, for this trip, unlike when Janet and I went to Sperry Chalet, we have to take our own food up. They don't provide any. So here are my choices. Chicken mac and cheese, chicken tikka masala, dehydrated. So we'll need two dinners, three lunches, and two breakfasts. A couple fig bars, some Starbucks instant coffee, some turkey jerky. We'll see how that is. I haven't tried it yet. I got some licorice in case I have a sweet tooth up there. I got oatmeal for breakfast. I have two packs of pistachios and some trail mix. I got these little fruit bars. Six of those. I got two Kind bars. A couple other bars, just in case. There's no refrigeration, so, you know, you gotta do what you can. We also have to take our own dishes up. So Janet loaned me this mug, and I have this little dish that turns in, I got from the Bob Marshall people, that turns into a, it's either a plate or a bowl. It turns into both. I think I'm pretty well prepared. I better be. We spent Friday night at a hotel right outside the park in St. Mary's. Saturday morning, we got up early. We were at the coffee shop at 6 a.m. to get coffee and breakfast. Janet bought us each these great matching bear and moose tattoos, which we applied Friday night. It was really fun. As you can see, we are super excited to start this trail. As you can see from this sign they have out there at the start of the trail, they do warn people about how hard this hike is. We did learn that the most rescues happen between the chalet and what they call the loop down there. And they want people to make sure they have what they need to finish this hike. And here's a pretty picture of some explorers' gentian flowers before we start the scary portion of this hike. A nice fellow hiker offered to take our picture along the way, and there were a ton of wildflowers.
After these two are a little long.
Yeah, that's fine. Another one.
Oh.
See it?
Oh yeah. Yeah. Should we stop here and have it take off your pack brake?
Not a terrible. Oh, look at that view, Janet. Holy cow. Yeah, let's do.
All right.
Took at least two pack off breaks during that hike, and on this one another kind hiker attempted to take some pictures of our temporary tattoos for us. This is an American pika. They're very small, little rodent-like mammals. And since they don't hibernate, they collect wildflowers and grasses during the summer to get them through the winter. And they lay them out in the sun to dry the plants so they don't get moldy. We saw him running along with a big wildflower in his mouth. It was really cute. Yeah, go ahead. We'll see what he does.
Thanks, buddy.
That's cute.
He's got a little moth-eaten tail there.
Yeah, he does. What is mommy eating? Something. The moth-eaten tail because he's chewing on it. And after about 5 hours of hiking, we finally get our first look at the chalet in the distance.
We left at 7 in the morning. We arrived at 1:30 in the afternoon. No incidents, no accidents. Not bad.
Nope.
You did it.
We did it. We did it.
Would you do it again?
Don't ask me right now.
It was a trick question.
Nope.
You did it.
I did it. I did it.
Would you do it again?
Don't ask me right now.
It was a trick question.
Sorry, thank you.
Oh, you're welcome.
Granite Park Chalet is only open from June 25th through September 11th. They call it Granite Park because prospectors visiting the area in 1890 mistook the speckled Purcell lava to be granite. But in reality, there isn't any granite in Glacier, but the name stuck. Sitting at 6,690 feet in elevation, it is the highest chalet in Glacier. This is the main dining hall. This building is where our room was. And this is our room. Had a bunk bed, a desk, and a chair. A really nice view out our little tiny window. Luckily for us, the outhouse was very close to us. Thought that was really handy. You do have to gather your own drinking water. There is no electricity or running water up there. There is one so-called sink that they have set aside for you to wash your hands and brush your teeth. It doesn't really work. You get the water comes out of that little coffee pot thing. It's got water in it. So you can wash one hand at a time. Right next to it is where the four employees who work up there have their meals. These are the backpacks with 5-gallon jugs on them that the employees haul up their water in. Yeah. You sign up for mealtime, so you can, they only want a few people in the kitchen at a time, so it doesn't get too crowded when you come up to cook your meals. The kitchen is set up pretty nicely. They have a really nice propane stove up there. And then they do sell snacks and things. They sell water, snacks. If you didn't bring dehydrated food, they have some of those you can also buy. Janet brought up this great freeze-dried margarita cheesecake as a nice treat for us. They also post the weather report of the day, which I thought was really handy. And sometimes the views are good and sometimes they're not so great. A lot of day hikers come up and take a break up there and eat their lunch. They have all the mileage and the elevation gain on any hike that goes through there. Janet and I sat and did quite a bit of knitting in the main lodge, in the main dining room. And I really appreciate this beautiful scarf that I got from Linda at Joey Scarf Podcast. If anybody watches her, she's podcasting again. And I commented on how beautiful this pink and white scarf was, and she sent it to me. Thank you, Linda. We had one decent sunset up there. That was it. It was cloudy and smoky while we were there. It did clear up once during the night, and I got up and did what I could to get kind of a decent star picture, but that's all I got. So the next morning, which was Sunday, August 4th, Janet and I planned on hiking up to what is called the Grinnell Glacier Overlook. You can see the trail here. It goes straight up that mountain pretty much. Here's the trail on the map. The Granite Park Chalet is circled in red, and the trail is that little tiny purple mark, and the purple arrow is showing Grinnell Lake and Grinnell Glacier. It's pointing at that, and that is what we are hiking up to see.
And this is, to me, pretty steep.
Yep.
You're okay, baby. We're not going to mess with you.
You just keep going.
We're not going to mess with you. Don't do anything risky.
I think I'm going up there.
What?
I'm not going up there, am I?
No.
Okay. Holy crap. You're like, what? Of course we are. Of course we're going. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. Exactly. Holy. Holy cow, Janet. Oh, wow. Oh, my goodness. Thank you.
How was it?
Not better.
Not better?
Not better.
Oh no.
No, not really.
GoPro.
Okay, it's time to go home. We came up that yellow trail, came up to the red circle where Granite Park is, and now we're going out the purple trail where we have left a car near the Swift Current Inn and near Many Glacier.
Very nice. Nice moves. Wow. Oh. Oh. That's nice.
Glacier Campground, 6.8 miles. That is us.
We're shooting. Whoa, don't fall off.
You're right about the pack knocking you over.
Uh-huh. It will too. Oh my goodness.
What a weekend.
What a weekend. That is Swift Current Glacier behind us. That is gorgeous. I have never seen it before. We just spent our two nights up at the chalet, and at this point you will have seen everything you need to see and hear about it, other than our impressions. Now, I gotta say, Janet has, like I said, probably said before, Janet has been up there once before to spend the night.
Yeah.
And another time before that for a day hike.
Yep.
Which I gotta say, she's a little crazy, but whatever. And my first time, of course. Let's see, what would I say about it? There were four people working there, super nice people. They have the patience of a saint, I think.
Yes, they do.
Because I couldn't do their job. It's primitive. It's much more primitive than Sperry. I think you need to decide that what you're actually doing is going camping.
Yes.
Kind of glamping a bit. A bit.
You're camping, but you're sleeping in a bed.
Yeah, you're camping, but you're sleeping in a bed. Nobody's fixing your food.
There's no running water.
No running water, no electricity. Oh, we got people coming out. We're going to pause
see
for
you in a minute.
Sec. Yeah. All right, we're going again. So, primitive, the views. Holy cow. Sperry's nice because you get spoiled by people fixing your breakfast, lunch, and dinner. By having a nice place to brush your teeth.
Victoria was a little disappointed in the hygiene facilities.
Yeah, I'm not a person that likes to brush your teeth in front of other people, but I survived that. Sperry's views do not hold a candle to Granite's.
No, Granite is 180 degrees of wow.
Just beauty everywhere.
Yeah.
All right, what's your feelings? It's been like 10 years or since you've been up here?
Maybe more. I don't know, 10. I loved it again. I mean, the first time to do anything is always wow. And you know what you're getting into the second time, but it's still an amazing place. You feel like you've accomplished something when you hike in and you carry all your worldly possessions with you.
Yeah, our packs were really heavy, I gotta say. Yeah.
Good experience. Uh-huh. Nice people. Plenty of toilet paper.
They did provide toilet paper.
They did provide the toilet paper. We didn't have to bring that. That was nice.
And if you want to come next weekend, we'll do it again next weekend.
Will we?
Well, maybe not next
maybe
weekend.
Maybe not. Okay, I'm going to show a little bit of knitting that I did up there.
Numbers are rolling.
All right. All right. Janet brought Janet and I did some knitting up there. Janet and I. The views are just incredible right now. Wait till I show them to you. She worked on a sock for herself on yarn that she dyed with Kool-Aid. And we will show that to you at some point. I don't know where it is in your pack.
It's buried.
I'm not going to make you get that out. I brought up something to knit on, and I'm using this yarn, which I thought was perfect for this, because it is by Threads by Megan Nicole, and the colorway is Glacial, and I thought it was just really perfect for this trip, so I wanted to use that. I think it's really pretty.
It's not shining.
Oh, it's not.
Because it's not in the light.
Okay. How's that? Better?
Maybe.
Maybe. Sparkle, darn you. I'll show you. I finished. So it's, I'm knitting some gloves. I've knit this pattern before. It's the Fruit Loop Gloves by Natasha Sills, I believe is her name. And I love this pattern. I will say it's not the easiest. It took me a while to figure it out. And if you don't like fiddling with, you know, fingers, then you're probably not going to want to knit gloves. How's that?
I don't know. I can't tell.
That's okay.
We'll take what we can get.
We're doing our best. And yeah, I love this pattern. They fit nice. I make the cuff quite a bit longer than they call for because I like a nice long cuff.
Yeah.
So I got the first one done before we left the house, and I had the other one started on, and we got to work on them quite a bit. Okay. I think that's enough talking for now. Oh my gosh. Oh, good Lord. Oh. Oh. Wow. Oh my gosh. The trail goes down there. Oh my gosh. Wow. What's up? What?
It here in the middle of this rock.
Isn't that beautiful? I turned my camera on just so I could get some of those.
The bumblebees and the moths love it.
You can't see it.
Before you go, I have a question.
Okay. At least
3, 7, 11. I'll say 11.
There always has to be one.
Stop at the top.
There always has to be one swinging bridge, doesn't there?
Yeah. You're all right there?
Yep. Fly.
Not exactly.
Yeah.
The kind of.
Yeah.
Wildlife we want to see.
That's okay.
Bunnies, snakes.
Yeah. He looks like a pika from here.
Does he?
Yeah. You can hardly see his ears. He's just. I think he's terrified.
Yeah.
It's like, what are they doing?
Hold still, they'll leave you alone.
Yeah. When we got back to the car, Janet had left a big cooler in there with a couple blocks of ice, and she had brought bottles of water, iced coffee. I had brought an iced coffee too. She'd brought Gatorade. She had apples, celery sticks, carrot sticks, and trail mix for us to have. I tell you, nothing tasted better than that iced coffee and those carrot sticks and celery sticks. I didn't get a picture of them, but man, they really hit the spot when we were finished.